Hey guys, and welcome back to the second Attila run mission. Apparently, we're in for a great ride, so let's go!
Now that the memories had stirred, Father Armand seemed eager to tell his tale. He explained how the Huns, like the other barbarians, had a style of warfare dramatically different from the ancient Romans or my own Franks. The Huns would charge as one group, often firing arrows as they came, and then suddenly retreat again. For the nations of Europe, who were used to forming up lines and columns, and even issuing challenges for personal combat, this was an aberration. They were unable to comprehend warfare in this manner. Barbarians did not conquer lands. They did not try and hold and colonize the cities they attacked. Instead, they ravaged and pillaged, and took their loot back to their camps. By that time, there were two Roman empires, the government having decided that the Roman lands were simply too vast for one city to manage effectively. Attila and the Huns began a series of raids into the Eastern Empire.
All right. So raid the Roman villages. Once you have enough resources to build a forward base, then you can field an army against the Romans. Each of the small villages, not counting the Roman fort, has a resource: food, wood, golden stone, villagers, and troops. Your Tarkins will suggest what to do in each village to capture a resource. This is a raid, get what you can and get out. Destroying some buildings will grant you resources, but it is not necessary to raise every enemy building. Notice locations of resources, you might need them at a later date. Huns are still confined to the castle age, alright. Your scouts report, Attila's Huns invade the Eastern Roman Empire with several cavalry, but no villagers. They expect only token resistance from all the villages. The exception is the Roman army, which has a fortified base to the east. Do not attempt to invade it until you are prepared. The other villages may have food, wood, gold, stone, villagers, or troops that you can use to challenge the Romans. Alright. Oops. Ooh.
The Roman Empire is fielding their army. We must hasten with our raid so that we have enough resources to train our own army.
Okay, I agree. Oh. Apparently the Huns were big fans of hitting and running.
Let us raid the Sophia Town Center with our Tarkins and see what loot we may find.
I liked his, the way he said that. So apparently we'll get resources from destroying buildings, and I'm not sure if we'll get resources from destroying houses, but at least for that, I want to kill villagers so they don't garrison that many. But I want to kill them while they're away, so we won't lose much HP on our tokens while we take it out. Will they even garrison? Yeah, they will. Let me show you a trick you can do. So you take the targeted Tarkin, you just go patrolling, and they will never be hit, ever. So let's see what resource we get from this. Tarkins are so strong in these buildings, it's insane.
The Sophians had much food stockpiled in the town center.
Nice, thank you, Sophia. Sophia! On to the next! So I guess we'll have to raid like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Out, we're gonna raid the Scythians. Yeah, like 5. Oh! Am I even supposed to attack this? I assume so. Just gonna have these debate the fire of the onager. And let's see if we actually get something from taking out this. There's a flag here. So it indicates this is of value somewhat. Guess not.
I remember this place. They took several of our raiders prisoner before. We must rescue our Hun brothers held at the castle before they are executed.
I agree. There's apparently a castle we need to take out here. Hutens, though, they have murder rolls, most likely. Or there are a few leashes, maybe not. We don't have many forces, though, so I hope this will be enough. Take out. It's too little lag, I'm not used to this. See if the market gives us any resource. Nope. Just gonna hit and run these bad boys. Roman scout! Oh no. Yeah, let's try and locate the castle. I guess it's in between these walls. Hello, villager, can you please open the gates for us? Oh, a lot of barracks. Oh, I guess we'll just have to try and take it out. I'm afraid we might lose a couple of units though to the castle. That's my concern. I mean, I'm not used to playing with absolutely zero lag. It's really hard to oh, you're gonna open the door for us? Nice. I mean, we'll just take out the gate anyway. Already there. Let's see what's in store for us. Well, I guess there's gonna be a... Wait, maybe it was just... They said we need to take out a castle. So I assume there's a castle somewhere we need to take out. Let me just double check what I said. It took several... Held at the castle, okay. Oh! I see. Let's take out a TC first, see if we get loot. Let's use one Jebaiter. Okay, no loot here. Let's use this guy to take the fire. Oh! Oh, I get reinforcements. Oh, okay, that didn't work. Please take out the Hussar first. Let's see if we can do anything like this. Ah, it's too close. It's impossible to avoid the shots. I guess we'll take it down, but we're gonna suffer some casualties here. But at the same time, most of them were reinforcements anyway. Oh, now we can maybe do it. Which one is being targeted? Okay, this guy. Okay, now we can avoid the shots and take minimal losses. Alright, good stuff. We might still die though. Worthy sacrifice. Well, I mean, we lost more than we saved there almost. So I don't know if that's really good trade for us. But alright, on to the next. We're teal red, so green, grey, purple at least. Left three more. Assume we're just gonna find. They said Romans were to the east, if I'm not mistaken. So we'll just keep going down south for now. See what we can find. Assume we're gonna get. Yeah, we're gonna get villagers eventually. Stone. A couple of farms we could take potentially. There's gold here. Okay, since we're limited to 75 population this game. Last game we were at 125. Oh. This is unacceptable. Oh, he got a conversion off. This is bad.
Huns do not need houses. Let us burn these to the ground and then take these villagers with us.
Oh, might get vills here. Oh, I shouldn't have killed the vills then. Well, maybe we'll get new villagers spawned in when we take out the houses. Hope so.
The locals speak of wild Scythian that dwells somewhere nearby. You should be cautious.
Wild Scythians? Oh no. Yeah, we're gonna avoid, try not kill the villagers. We might get them for our own after we take out the houses. So what did I just say now? The locals speak of wild Scythians that dwell somewhere nearby. You should be cautious. Alright. As you wish. Wonder where, though. As soon as the houses are taken down, I guess we're gonna get villagers. We don't have anything we could do with them yet, though. So we don't. We might get this market, and we could trade resources to buy lumber camps, for example.
Now these peasants will do our bidding. Let us find a suitable location to establish our camp.
Yeah, I should not have killed these two villages in hindsight, but how could I know? Take out the market and the docks as well, just to see if we get anything. Yeah, I'm a little bit curious about those Scythians, where they are hiding. I mean, I guess we'll just follow what the Tarkins say when it comes to what we should do. We have four veils though, I assume we should not waste them. That seems to be blind's path. Try and keep them alive so we can actually rebuild our base, or build a base, rather. There might be someone here though, or even maybe I've skipped someone. Might have to go back to have a look. This is a nice place to build a base though, so I'm just gonna stay there with the vills. Don't think I'll get attacked from there. See if there's something down here. Guess we can spread out a little bit more, find what we're looking for. Check down here as well, because why not? Oh.
Gold mines of Adrianople deserve to be planted. Let's destroy all of their mining camps.
Another two Tarkins. Rip. But we're gonna get gold here, I assume. See, I'm pretty smart, guys. Okay, that's gray. I'll use the coward just to scout more meanwhile. On the other side. I assume we're going to be approaching the Roman building soon. If we continue to the east, they should be around here. So I don't know if there's any more of these in this road. So we'll go back. I think we might have run past something. Have a quick look. Just spread out. See if there's anything we missed. There might be more though, and the Roman emperors might not have that much. But still, I think there might be some
Roman gold.
That we got gold.
There is no other metal that shines as sweetly.
Need to find a place where we can get wood. This seems like people are chopping wood there, so there might be something here. Okay, I'm pretty sure we're gonna find like wood stuff here. But it must be, right? Why else would there be so many chopped trees? Send one Tarkin this way, just in case. Maybe I was wrong. Another gold. This will also be a nice place to start base. I would like to be starting it up as close as possible. Okay, purple might be this. No, wait, purple's down here. Wait, what is this? Yeah, you can't pass there. Maybe we have to continue to the east. See what this guy finds. Yeah, we have no wood income at the moment. We don't have access to a market either.
If we attack the Roman fort with too few soldiers, we will surely die.
Well, where am I supposed to find wood then? I guess up here. I assume they're going to be around in this black spot then, since the Romans are all the way up here.
Beyond this moat is the Roman fort. We should avoid it until we are ready.
I hear you, mate, but I need wood. Oh, orange. Scythian. They're the Scythians, probably. Might want to muster my forces here. Whoa, we have purple, red, teal, gray. Where's green?
The town of Nisus produces the best lumber.
Okay,
Let us take all we can by destroying these lumber camps.
Let's go there first and we'll check out the Scythians after that. Just gonna gather my units so we lose as little as possible. Let's kill this villager. I think they might call GG after we kill her. Saw her running around earlier as well. Or maybe not. Okay, let's see if they have any units here. Don't see any units. I don't want to kill the villagers just yet, just in case they might switch color after we take out their lumber camps. Let's check out this trade workshop as well. Might get something from that. Hoping the villagers will switch side when we kill this, destroy the lumber camps. That would be nice. And to be honest, blue doesn't seem like they have a lot of area, so they shouldn't have much. I'm not sure how much we'll actually need to take them out. Could go on a YOLO mission with just what we have after we heal it up. And see if we can actually take it out. Some micro and such. See if the villagers will switch color.
We have captured all of Nisus's lumber.
Nope. Alright. We are starting in Castlage, so that's nice. We'll just make one here, next to the farms. And we can have a close to the TC as well. Okay, I wonder if there should be something with the Scythians happening. So we're just gonna go there now. See what actually happens here. And I wonder if we'll actually get upgrades on these units. Wait, see, some of them has up... Oh, this one, these ones we probably got from... Yeah, we got a few on the on this... spot here where we freed them from the enemies. Yeah, I want to make a blacksmith just to see if we can get some upgrades. More upgrades. I'm not scared of blue. Come at me, bro. I want to see a little bit what they have. Mangonels, crossbows, locked gate, fair enough. Point taking out these outposts, but for style points, you know. Let's see if we get Bodkin on these cavalry arches. Woo!
Now that we have a base, we must train many riders to withstand the Roman attack and then go on the offensive.
Must train many riders. Sounds good. I agree. Oh! Okay, we got Balkin. Oh, they're attacking us! Oh no! I want a stable. Oh shit. Should maybe not have attacked, initiated the fight yet. Let's do a second this and... I want to do husbandry, but then again, we don't have nearly enough food. I want to do like hit and run stuff. I don't want to fight this yet. We'll lure them to our town center, I think. See how that goes. They're moving so quickly as well. We don't have nearly enough villagers even. Make this TC strong. Oh, killed the deer by mistake. Feels bad. Are these Celtic pikes or what? They're moving so fast. We have the hill. Camp it. Might even want to make a market just to be able to speed up things with buying things with stone. Actually, if we're lucky, maybe this is all of their forces, and we'll be able to just go and break them now. I was not anticipating this attack, though, I must admit. came a little bit soon. I mean, maybe this is actually all their forces, pretty much. Put someone on wood. Pick out this. Well, we lost a lot of units, but so did they. So we'll see. I'll go have a look-see around their base again and approach the Scythians. We take out this lumber camp. I would have liked to have a monastery just to heal up as. Should probably leave at least the most wounded ones behind. They're just gonna be one hit, one kills anyway. Let's see now. I wonder if the other guys will actually do anything to us. Like Gray, for example, do they even have anything to do something with us? Hope not. I'm just leaving them all alive. Not getting them defeated. My hopes are that the Scythians will offer some kind of deal or treaty or something that they won't attack us. This might be, but they did say watch out, right?
Like, oh, the looks of this.
Yeah, there's a lot of dead bodies. Do I want to go in here or not? I mean, come on, I saved their Scythian scout the last game. Oh, I can't click them. Oh, they're ally. Do I want to go here?
Most foolish to trespass here. If you bring us six of your villagers, we will make it worth your while.
Six villagers? You mean these guys on the horses? Yeah. No, I'm gonna actually give them six villagers since that's what they're asking for. Yeah, we haven't really been that clever with bringing stuff previously. This time I'm just gonna listen to what they say. I think we're gonna run these back just to heal them up. Hopefully we won't run into any enemies on the way with the villagers. Oh, in return for their assistance. Okay. We are limited cast lich. Actually, let's make a monastery forward here. Well, we have villages here. Might as well just throw a monastery up there. Wait, did I bring the... Wait, where are my Tarkins? Oh, there you are. Okay. And there you go. I should send one bit. We'll just do it like this. For now. Almost out of deer. We have at least steady villager production. And we'll see what we actually get from these. Hopefully the... Yeah, the wolves are out. Never mind, they're allies. Never mind, they won't attack us. Yeah, we'll just get this. We'll heal these guys up. Might run in and see what's up. And... Yeah, well, first of all, let's see what we actually get in return from Orange.
We thank you for this gift. Your reward waits in the clearing to the north.
Okay. Guess we'll go have a look.
Merchant.
Okay. Wonder what our reward will be. Could just go and make a meal here, but I'm lazy. Let's see what's up here. In the clearing to the north. Assume it was... Oh. Woo! Okay. Alright, now we're talking. Ay. I can get on board with this. Let's send a few villagers to make some forward things. I think we're happy with the villager count we have right now. And the resources we're gonna get. I don't think they have much, actually. In their base anymore. We're just gonna heal up. And once we're healed up, we'll run in. I think they sent most of the units out to attack, actually. Wait, wolves don't get recognized as enemies, right? So you can just run in and scout with this guy. Click him there so he runs faster. Oh, never mind. I was wrong. Oh, there's actually a gate. But arrows are so inaccurate anyway. Send two guys just to blow up the gate. Hey, not the wolf. Okay, we're healed. Actually, I think we're just gonna try and see if we can break them with this. Make a siege workshop just in case. Bada boom! Okay, so... Yeah, let's just run in. I think, yeah, like... Oh, the wolves are probably super strong. Let's convert these three. Oh, they actually have a lot of units. Might need some siege, okay. Here we go. Attack! Wonder if the wolves will auto-attack after you put them onto something, right? Will they automatically be aggressive towards the next unit? Huh? Seems they are. Nice. Yeah, we're cleaning this up pretty nicely. Those six villagers were definitely worth it, I would say. Oh, there's a castle. Well, time for these guys to show their worth. Should probably have made some more production facilities. In hindsight. We don't actually have that many units anymore. Might have moved in a little bit too quick here. I just want to get this castle down. Let's go! Boom boom! Oh, Byzantine's castle though. A lot of HP. Damn it! Didn't go down. Hope they won't repair it. We don't have units anymore! We're losing. Oh no. Alright. Let's make a stable or two. Should have made gathered a stone and made a castle and just made more Tarkins to raid everything. Okay. Oh! He's just got the knights converted. That's all I ask. Okay. These wolves were useless. Convert him, please. Here we go. Yeah, we don't really have many forces left. Actually, let's make a market. Where was the stone again? It was up here. Ah, it's pretty far. Yeah, we moved in a little bit too quick. But as long as they don't repair the castle, I won't complain. they repair the castle though, then that would be a little bit annoying. Do I have husbandry? Maybe I already started with husbandry. No, I did not. Just make monks. I'm planning to buy like 400 stone with the market just to get the castle up, you know? Make some hussar. You could probably just make. They have actually just keep making units. Damn it! It might be good for us though, actually. We might be able to just convert more knights. Send the ram out, see if we can bait some units out. Oh, there we go. We're actually making a lot of units. But I think we're cleaning most with our conversions. This should be it. Just make a castle here now. Let's wait until the ram is gone. We don't want any accidents to take place here. Or do we? Try and drop it here now. Should be okay. We have enough. We actually have a lot of knights now. I think we might have enough now actually to break them. Just make. Yeah, we'll just send the ram in. We have so many knights now. Yeah, we should have enough now, I think. Send these monks in and heal. No, they're repairing the castle! Ay, that was not part of the plan. Man! Send our villagers in to repair. To repair the... our lonely ram. That was not part of the plan. They're focus firing our bills. Oh, it almost seemed that way. A little bit there. And now it should be right. Sending Tarkins and Rams in at the castle. It doesn't seem to have murder holes, so that's good. Yeah, it's going down now. Can't pick the pikeman behind the. There we go. Oh, died. Fine. At least we broke them. Let's try to take the PC as well. After that, we should be victorious. Power rush. Let's do it. Tower and T's villagers. I mean villagers and then and the TC should be enough to force out the GG. At least that's what I think based on previous experience. Seems to be villagers. Oh yeah, there we go. Nice. You should fear for the future of the Empire. It's Attila the Hun is here. And the tower rush. There we go. Got him. Okay, so yeah, Yeah, we should have sent some. I expected the blue to have more of the map. But I figured I'd just go this way. And yeah, wood was what we probably wanted first, I would say. But yeah. Yeah, it was fine. It was fine. We got the job done. Good stuff. Let's turn this up a little bit and then listen to what they say.
The Roman city of Nisus was erased from the earth. The Huns so devastated the place that when the Roman ambassadors passed through to meet with Attila, they had to camp outside the city on the river. The riverbanks were covered with human bones, and the stench of death was so great that no one could enter the city. Many cities of Europe would soon suffer the same fate. The ambassadors that the Romans sent to Attila concealed an assassination attempt. Somehow, Attila knew of the attempt on his life and sent the terrified assassin back to his emperor with the gold he had been paid to do the deed in a sack tied to his neck. Following such a demonstration, the Huns had no difficulty convincing the Eastern Roman Empire to start paying them a tribute, protection money, to stave off the inevitable Hun invasion.
Good stuff. Pause the screens now if you want to see any of the achievements. Or go back a few seconds. Alright, so that was the great ride. It was an interesting. I like these types of campaigns where there are like different tasks here and there, different choices to make and stuff like this. It's like, I think they're really well made. Especially when you take into consideration how old this game actually is. And how old these campaigns are. They're really well made, I find. Alright, so the next one will be the Walls of Constantinople. Oh, interesting. We keep circling back and forth between the same cities and areas with all the campaigns. Yeah, hopefully you guys enjoyed this episode, and I'll see you for the next one.